always forget. Okay, so welcome back, and I'm going to do some more of these puddle base pour things. I don't know what the name is for, because I have no idea what people call it, but that's my name for it, puddle pour things. All right. So I want to spread it out all over. Oops. I don't want it to all run off the edges, but I do want it to get to the edges. So, just doing it like this. It's quiet today. My husband isn't mowing the lawn or anything. This is fairly thick paint, this base that I've got. Like, you can see it doesn't just, it has quite a puddle when you run it off. Fairly thick. But it's just house paint. Plain house paint. With water, a little bit of water in it. And sometimes I use pearl, and sometimes I use gloss, and just about any kind. I get whatever's on sale usually. Okay, that's good for that. And now I want to pour. I should have mixed my paint and paint. I'll just take this off of here for a minute and put it over here so I can pour my little cup full of what I want to have. And I want to have red. I don't need too much. Oh, that's right. I'm just going to pour puddles on, so I'm not going to put it in a cup. Gee, I'm forgetting what I want to do myself. Okay, start over. Here we are again. So, I'm going to pour my little puddles on out of the jar. Okay, and I'm going to use red. I don't know, I'm on a red kick now. Red, and another red up here further. And I want, that's not gold. Okay, where did I put it? Must be here somewhere. Oh, this is it. This is my gold. So I will put a puddle. Oops, that's a bigger puddle than I wanted. These jars, I like them for everything, except they don't pour as nice as some of the others. Oh, and I want to put some white in this. I do want white. Oh, I didn't mix that good enough. It's okay. Well, we'll get whatever we get out of it. And this was copper, but I mixed some red in it, copper metallic, because I just don't like copper that much. Okay, so I'm going to blow these out, so it'll be noisy for a minute. Way, way too much paint on here, but I'm going to pour a bunch of it off. I'm going to spin it once, that will get rid of a lot of the excess. Okay, that's not exactly what I wanted, but I'm going to pour some off this way. I'm still going to spin it because I don't like that. Get a lot of this off. Then I can add on to it later, which I plan on adding some white to it. Yeah, just way, way more paint than what I needed. Okay, see what we can do with this. My spatula. Okay, so now I'm going to pour some more paint in there and spread it around. Now my spatula is so dirty, but I've got so much junky paint stuck on it. I'll clean that off. I'll clean it off good right now. I really don't like that one at all. I don't know what will happen to it. I don't know what can happen to it that is going to make me like it, but because I have way too much paint on it. First of all, I'm going to try to tilt some of this down. Oh yeah, it still does. It's going to go down some, so no, that'll be a good thing. It's not all going down, but some of it is. As you can see, of course, it's not going down here because as I scraped all the paint off of it. Okay, I'm gonna put some white paint back in there. Oops. This jug of paint is pretty well empty, so I'm going to just spread this. Well, I don't know if I'll spin it or if I'll just tilt it. Okay, I think that's going to work all right. Tilting. Yeah. That weight is moving over quite a bit. Have a skewer that's bigger than the ones that I have. There it goes. I don't think I'm going to get as big a... Next time I go to town, I'll get some more, but I just haven't got them yet. Oops. I forget I have to hang on to everything. I like these lines, but I only like them if they're going in. I don't like all those little dangly ends sticking out. Too much to do this on. I'm going to do it on all of this side. Thank you. this side, I think, because I cut off the really the nice part of this edge, so this will give it a nicer edge. This is quite a bit of open space here. Oops, wrong way. Okay. I hope you're not just seeing my big head here while I'm all bent over doing this. That would be a pretty sight today. Okay. Okay, I like that. That's kind of what I'm going for, but I had way too much paint on this, and I haven't gone to town yet to get a new, take my gloves off, to get a new, what do you call them, a new one of these little torches, so I'm going to see if I can, this one looks like it might go. It always, this paint always dries up on it wherever I've last used it. It's so sticky always. Let me see if I can make it move. Oops. Oh yeah, there we go. Out. Okay. Now I can put more stuff in that one. I don't know, it feels full, but it's the same. They're both exactly the same torches, but everything I use is so stuck up with paint that, okay, no torch until I put fill that one up after this one's done. Okay, so I'm going to call that one a keeper. And I can make some room for it here. Get out of the way. It's just my own ideas. I haven't seen anybody do this, but I'm kind of having fun with it, so I'm just going with it until I get tired of it, and then I'll do something else. Alright, thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the dried results.